Australian military hardware will soon be bound for Germany under a record agreement signed today. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese in Berlin to ink the deal, representing a billion-dollar boost to our manufacturing sector.
In a city once split in two, a signature binding Berlin and Brisbane as the world threatens to divide once more. German company Rheinmetall will produce 100 Boxer heavy weapon carrier vehicles in Brisbane beginning 2025. The contract worth at least $1 billion Australian dollars, creating roughly 1,000 jobs.
This is good for our defence, this is good for our national sovereignty, but it's also good for our economy.
One of the largest military export deals in our history, the multi-role fighting vehicles will boost German capability as military donations to Ukraine and the threat of war in Europe sparks a major expansion.
The German Chancellor is equipping the German military to fight a war against Russia that only makes sense if Ukraine fails.
It had been a military welcome for the Prime Minister in Europe's largest power. Tonight, a meeting with Chancellor Olaf Scholz in the midst of free trade negotiations between Australia and the EU, with Germany eyeing Australian critical and rare earth minerals, crucial for green energy, manufacturing and cars.
I see enormous opportunity for Australia to benefit from the shift to clean energy that's occurring.
But Russia's invasion of Ukraine looms large. Both leaders will travel to the NATO summit in Lithuania, where Volodymyr Zelensky will continue to push for Ukraine to join the alliance.
I don't think there is unanimity in NATO about whether or not to bring Ukraine into the NATO family.
Granting membership during the war would require all NATO nations to be in direct conflict with Russia, greatly increasing the chances of a nuclear war.
I don't think it's ready for membership in NATO.
And the Prime Minister will soon meet with Germany's Chancellor. Let's go live to Charles Croucher in Berlin. Charles, how can Australia benefit from a better relationship?
Evening, Pete. Well, Germany is Europe's largest economy and therefore it is the loudest voice at the table as those negotiations between Australia and the European Union over free trade play out. Energy will be crucial. Berlin is moving away from Russian gas and Australian critical minerals and green hydrogen have emerged as a potential replacement. That makes us a much more attractive prospect when it comes to free trade. For consumers across Sydney, Europe's manufacturing might will cause the price of some goods to go down. In particular, tonight we're being told electric vehicles made in Germany could soon become available in Australia for cheaper prices, and we know that price is such a big hurdle for so many people to getting an electric car. Pete, that meeting will take place in the coming hours.
Charles Croucher in Berlin, thank you.